President Marcos has placed government agencies on high alert amid the threat of Typhoon Marcel. Preemptive evacuations are now underway in some parts of northern Luzon, which were severely battered by the recent storms. In Isabela alone, over 800 families have already evacuated. The president also instructing the budget department to prepare for the release of quick response fund.
QRF natin, ang katotohanan dyan dahil sa dami ng bagyo ay naubos na. Kaya ang ginawa natin ay nagtabi ulit tayo ng pondo para mabigyan ulit, malagyan na naman natin ng laman ang QRF natin para sa mga local governments at sa kanilang at sa inyong mga pangangailangan.
Former Philippine President Rodrigo Duterte will skip a joint House panel's probe on his administration's bloody war on drugs. Duterte's counsel says the former president doubts the integrity and independence of the House Quad Committee. Duterte called the inquiry a political ploy to indict him for crimes he did not commit. He insists his presence at the committee's November 7th hearing is unnecessary. The ex-president was a no-show at the QuadCom's hearing last month and claimed he felt unwell at the time. Now, after two impeachments, 34 felony counts, and a conviction, Donald Trump is months away from returning to the White House. After cruising to the 270 electoral votes needed to win the race, Trump now has 294 after winning nearly all seven swing states. The races in Nevada and Arizona are yet to be called, but Trump is leading in both. Harris has 223 electoral votes.
America has given us an unprecedented and powerful mandate. We have taken back control of the Senate. Wow, that's good. And the Senate races in Montana, Nevada, Texas, Ohio, Michigan, Wisconsin, the great Commonwealth of Pennsylvania. We're all won by the MAGA movement. They helped so much. Frankly, this was, I believe, the greatest political movement of all time.
Republicans also gained three seats at the Senate, retaking control of the chamber.
Let me start by congratulating President Trump. What he's accomplished has not been done, as all of you know, since Grover Cleveland, which was a while back. I also want to commend the Trump campaign for running a sharper operation this time. Simple answer. I think it was a referendum on the current administration, in part. People were just not happy with this administration, and the Democratic nominee obviously was a part of it.
Vice President Kamala Harris did what Donald Trump refused to do in 2020. Addressing his supporters in Washington, D.C., Harris conceded to Trump after results showed a major shift to the right among U.S. voters. She also vowed to take part in a peaceful transfer of power.
Now I know folks are feeling and experiencing a range of emotions right now. I get it. But we must accept the results of this election. Earlier today, I spoke with President-elect Trump and congratulated him on his victory. I also told him that we will help him and his team with their transition, and that we will engage in a peaceful transfer of power.
Speaking before an emotional crowd, Harris tried to reassure her supporters, her voice cracking at times, that the fight they started will continue.
So let me say, my heart is full today. My heart is full today, full of gratitude for the trust you have placed in me, full of love for our country, and full of resolve. The outcome of this election is not what we wanted, not what we fought for, not what we voted for. But hear me when I say, hear me when I say, the light of America's promise will always burn bright as long as we never give up and as long as we keep fighting.
President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. congratulates former U.S. President Donald Trump on his victory. He says he looks forward to working with Trump on several issues that would benefit the two nations. Marcos Jr. described the U.S.-Philippine alliance as unshakable and hopes this will be a force for good, especially in the Indo-Pacific region. The Philippine president expressed optimism that Trump's leadership will result in a better future for everyone. New York Governor Kathy Hochul congratulates Donald Trump on his electoral win. But the Democrat also had firm words for the president-elect, saying the state will remain a bastion for freedom and rule of law. The governor issued the comments at a press conference with New York Attorney General Letitia James, who brought a civil fraud case against Trump in 2022.
I will be very clear. While we honor the results of this election and will work with anyone who wants to be a partner in achieving the goals of our administration and our state, that does not mean we'll accept an agenda from Washington that strips away the rights that New Yorkers have long enjoyed.
I congratulate the president-elect Donald Trump. And if possible, we will work with his administration. But we will not compromise our values or our integrity or our principles. We did not expect this result, but we are prepared to respond to this result.
Trump declared victory as soon as the race in Pennsylvania was called for him. But for many young voters in the state, Trump's victory was unexpected, even for those who voted for him.
I think what I'm expecting to see and what a lot of people who voted for Donald Trump are expecting to see is I think the economy was the biggest reason as to why he won.
Yes, I was very shocked. I was very confident that Kamala and Walz would win, but I guess our country is more uneducated than I thought.
In Wisconsin, another swing state, Trump won. Locals are still trying to make sense of the election results.
So far from what we've seen, he's won both electoral votes and popular votes. So I think this country is a bit more conservative than a lot of other people thought. And I don't know how to think about that. I think that just like reevaluates how a lot of people feel about living in this country in general, not just the election. So
dozens of protesters gathered outside the U.S. Embassy in London after Donald Trump secured his victory. The protest, organized by campaign groups Stand Up to Racism, was labeled a No to Trump demonstration. Protesters say the Trump campaign leaned heavily on racism, bigotry, misogyny, and Islamophobia, and are worried the same tone will be set by his presidency.
That is obviously the big fear, that with Trump we'll see an escalation of discrimination, of racism. What he will do is to mobilize those forces of fascism and inequality in this country and elsewhere, and therefore it's important that we come together and oppose that.
My fears is that democracy will suffer massively in the United States. The rights for women, free choice, like about abortion rights, will I think be really impaired. I think he's someone who whips up racism, which is really problematic, and I don't know if he has the skills to really help the U.S. economy, because I'm not convinced. He's just politically very toxic and divisive, and I think it will just polarize the United States even more.
Let's get an update now on the U.S. elections from ABS-CBN's Henny Espinosa. Hi, good morning, Henny. What can you tell us?
Good morning, Bettina. So Donald Trump has been elected the 47th president of the United States. What an amazing comeback for the former president who refused to accept defeat 4 years ago.
The 78-year-old Trump claimed victory in the 2024 U.S. presidential election in the early hours of Wednesday, declaring an unprecedented and powerful mandate as he addressed supporters in Florida, despite many states still counting votes.
Frankly, this was, I believe, the greatest political movement of all time. There's never been anything like this in this country and maybe beyond. And now it's going to reach a new level of importance because we're going to help our country heal. We're going to help our country heal. We have a country that needs help, and it needs help very badly. We're going to fix our borders. We're going to fix everything about our country. And
the president-elect, flanked by family members and key allies, asserted wins in several battleground states and a Senate majority for his party.
America has given us an unprecedented and powerful mandate. We have taken back control of the Senate. Wow, that's great. And the Senate races in Montana, Nevada, Texas, Ohio, Michigan, Wisconsin, the great Commonwealth of Pennsylvania, were all won by the MAGA movement. They helped so much.
Leading into Tuesday, Election Day, polls showed a dead heat between the former president and Vice President Kamala Harris. But by 2 a.m. Eastern Time, Trump had won the swing states of North Carolina and Georgia and was leading in several others, according to Edison Research. For her part, Harris called President-elect Trump on Wednesday to concede the election and congratulate him on his victory, as well as to talk about a peaceful transfer of power, according to a senior advisor to the vice president. Beth Moyer, a resident of McAllister, Oklahoma, says she waited years to vote for the first time in the U.S. elections, and she's elated her choice for president won. This Filipina is confident Trump will make America great again.
Mr. Trump vowed not to make cuts on Social Security and Medicare, and his concerns for the elderly is admirable. Last night in his speech, he mentioned about no taxes on Social Security benefits, and I'm so happy. I, for one, is looking forward to my pension next year, and that's good news.
Supporters of President-elect Trump gathered early Wednesday near Mar-a-Lago to celebrate his return to the White House, including Filipina Mimi Israela, who believes Trump's victory represents a larger hope for stability in America and abroad.
You know, we took a country back, and we're going to return it back to be great again. Yeah, so it's the victory not only for us Americans, but also for peace to other countries, especially Israel.
It's not over.
In Southern California, Philippine-born Jessica Calosa has a giant lead in her quest to become the first Filipina woman to be elected to California's State Assembly. As of early Wednesday morning, Calosa had over 72,000 votes, more than double her opponent Frankie Carrillo's 35,000-plus votes. Despite the big gap, Calosa was not declaring victory on Tuesday night.
I feel really good, but we have to make sure that every vote is counted, right? Every single person's vote is counted. And so while we feel good, you know, tonight is about celebrating our progress so far. This is not a victory celebration by any means. This is really more of a thank you.
Among those celebrating Calosa's success at the polls, Philam State Attorney General Rob Bonta, who she serves as chief of staff for.
She's going to be a leader among leaders on day one. And that's the Jessica we know. But now I'm very honored to say, as the first Filipino-American state legislator ever elected to legislator in California that all of you and Jessica decided to pick up a pen and write history, and now you have the first Filipina-American legislator in the history.
Calosa is not the only Filipino expected to join the California state legislature. In Northern California, former West Sacramento Mayor Christopher Cabaldon declared victory in his state Senate race. Cabaldon, a Democrat, finished election night with a 61-38% lead over Republican Tom Boog with 100% of precincts voting. Cabaldon will be the first Philam to hold a California state Senate seat.
We are monitoring other races involving Filipino-American candidates and we'll be sure to report to you as soon as we hear more about it. But for the Filipino-American community here, what matters is that they practiced their right to vote, they made their voices heard, and they're representing the community in very important positions in government. Bettina.
All right. Thank you so much for the update. Kenny Espinosa.